This is Gwen from Lovin Motion Wellness. Invite you today to join me for another quick workout. We'll be using our drumsticks again today. If you don't have drumsticks available, a simple alternative to use would be wooden spoons from the kitchen. I'm going to review quickly a few of the moves that we'll be having in using the drumsticks, just to introduce you. Using for the arm workout, we'll be using some simple overstretch. This is a beginner workout, low impact. So we'll be using the drumsticks combined together with both hands, stretching them up and over the head. Next would be shoulder press, pull down, kind of like a lat pull down, using the drumsticks to strike above. And the others, combining them together again with a slight lunge to scoop and spin around back to the center. Okay, for leg workouts, we'll be using a simple squat. Anytime we're doing squats and the lunges, we want to pay attention to where your knees are positioned, keeping those knees aligned above the ankles and not protruding forward or too far back. We want to be healthy for our knees as we're working out. So for this, we'd be squatting, pivot to the side and strike, raise up in the center, pivot and strike on the other side. So the flow of that is going to look like that. And the last would be a reverse lunge, again paying attention to position of the front knee over top of the ankle and the foot, keeping that in a 90 degree bend with the reverse leg behind you. In that, using the drumsticks, we're going to strike down to the ground. If that's the too far reach, simply strike and lunge where you are able. Don't worry, if you're moving, you're doing well. So those are the basic moves that you'll find throughout this workout. So before we get started, I'd like to share a brief word with you from scripture. The scripture that we'll be speaking about and learning today as we work out comes from John chapter 1 verse 29. We start with John the Baptist, who declares when he sees Jesus, "Look, there he is, God's Lamb. He will take away the sins of the world." Following the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we then find Peter proclaiming at Pentecost in Acts chapter 2, verse 32 through 33. Peter says, "God has resurrected Jesus, and we have all seen him. Then God exalted him to his right hand upon the throne of highest honor, and the Father gave him the authority to send the promised Holy Spirit, which is being poured out upon us today. This is what you are seeing and hearing." Friends, this is the word of the Lord. And knowing that as we wholeheartedly and humbly repent and return to God, that as we believe in our hearts, confess with our mouth that our Lord is Jesus Christ, our Savior. Friends, we know that everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Friends, together, let's move in love. Let our workout be our worship today.
You bore our shame and paid the cost. Rewind.